Hey everyone, welcome back to another 3D Revolution. In this video, I'm going to be talking about a way you can turn your 3D printer on and off from anywhere in the world. It's never advisable to leave a 3D printer running unattended, let alone outside the house, but we all do it. When you've got a 130-hour print going, you're not going to sit and babysit it the whole time. So what do you do if something goes wrong? Well, if you've got a webcam, you could monitor it, and if you've got a Raspberry Pi running Octoprint, you could actually pause and stop it. But what if something goes wrong with the printer itself? If you get a short and it starts showing signs of magic smoke puffing on your webcam there, the only thing you can do to stop that getting any worse is to go and turn off the power to that printer. But if you're a few miles away, you're probably not going to make it back in time to do that. That's where these come in. There's a few different brands of smart plug that have started appearing on the internet recently. This is a TP-Link smart plug, and I bought a couple of these myself. These plug straight into the main socket on your wall, and then you plug your printer straight into these. You then connect these to your Wi-Fi network, and using an app on your mobile, you can then turn on and off these plugs from anywhere in the world. All you have to do is hit the power button next to those plugs, and you can see both my printers have just turned on. Then I can just set a print going and head out about my way. Then I can monitor it using Octoprint or just a standard webcam, and if I see anything going wrong, if there's something worrying me and I'd rather kill the print than lose my house, all I have to do is hit the power buttons again and off they go. I can now safely make my way home and see what the problem was. When you're buying these, it's worth taking into account the actual brand. As well as making sure that they're built well, you also want to make sure that it's a company that's going to be around for a while, which is why I went for the TP-Link ones. When you're using these inside your house, you're going directly via the Wi-Fi network, so even if you don't have internet, you can still use these inside your house. But if you want to access this from anywhere else, you need to use the company's server system. And if the company ceases to exist, you're not going to be able to use them outside the house anymore, so try and buy one from a brand that you think isn't going down anytime soon. TP-Link's one seems really easy to set up. The only issue I had was when you're setting up, it tries to, for some reason, connect to a Wi-Fi network that doesn't even exist. So you need to force it to find yours, and then you can log in, and from that point, everything is incredibly easy. I definitely recommend getting these if you do a lot of printing outside the house. It's an extra peace of mind, and it means that you could potentially save a real catastrophe if anything does go wrong. I'm probably also going to kit the rest of my house out with these because you can do some fun things if you plug lights into these. You can have it automatically turn them on and off when you're outside the house, make it look like people are in. You can have them do scheduling, so you could have it when you wake up in the morning. The lights turn on, you can have the kettle turn on. There's some fun things you can do with them, but for 3D printing, for me, it's mainly a safety thing, and it makes me feel a lot safer when I'm outside the house and I've left the print going, knowing that I can just shut that all down if anything looks wrong. So, check them out. I'll leave a link in the description below. Thanks for watching, and remember, hit subscribe for more news, tips, and live streams on everything 3D and tech.